Well, here goes. I want to share with you. I was praying on Sunday saying, God, please tell me how it's going to happen. And I hope I've got the word. But first of all, I want to say without question, Trump is going to win the election. That doesn't mean you sit home and don't vote. That means you get out and do everything you can to work. But he's going to win. That's, I think, a given. But after he is sworn in and his vice president is Mike Pence, then trouble is going to happen. He's going to be challenged by the Chinese, as you couldn't believe. He'll be faced probably with some kind of a war. The North Koreans are going to have nuclear weapons. They're going to threaten us. The Russians are going to do everything they can. The Turks have got their things going. And after Trump is sworn in, we're going to see civic disobedience in our America that will just be mind-boggling. The country will be torn apart. But you talk about Trump derangement syndrome, it's going to be horrible. Because already, without anything happening, we've got trouble in the streets. But there will be at least two attempts on the president's life. And it's going to be very difficult. So I would just urge you, you should pray for him. But now, in the process that this confusion is happening in America, and it looks like our country is being torn apart, the fulfillment will take place of Ezekiel 38's prophecy. And here's what it says. It says, therefore, son of man, prophesy and say to Gog, this is what the sovereign Lord says, in that day, when my people Israel are living in safety, will you not take notice of it? And you will come from your place to the far north, and many nations with you, all of them riding on horses, a great horde, a mighty army. You'll advance against my people Israel like a cloud that covers the land. In days to come, Gog, I will bring you against my land, that the nations may know me when I am proved holy through you before their eyes. Now, that's going to be next. You're going to have Trump win. You're going to have civic discourse. You're going to have at least two attempts on the life of the president. And, you know, you can just pray as to what's going to happen in relation to that. But this country is going to be torn apart. And it will be the opportunity for Erdogan and Iran to come together against Israel. And that's what Ezekiel says is going to happen, that there's going to be this tremendous horde. Now, who's going to be involved in coming against it? It's going to be the Muslim communities on the border of Russia. And Azerbaijan is just one of them. They're already trying to kill the Christians in Armenia. And so you're looking at the possibility, and there they are. But in addition, you've got Iran that hates Israel, and they want to destroy Israel. You have some of the other countries, I mean, you know, North Yemen, and there are a few nations in North Sudan that are Muslim, and they hate Israel. And that whole coalition is going to come together, and they're going to say, because America is so occupied, we are therefore going to invade Israel. This is going to be our opportunity to crush and destroy Israel. And so there's going to be a tremendous war against Israel. But the Bible says God himself is going to defend Israel, and he's going to wipe out that horde. It's not going to be a nuclear war, but God himself is going to wipe out that horde of people that are coming against Israel. Now, what's going to happen next? I mean, you say, all right, you got that's the next thing that's going to happen is that God is going to bring a period of great peace. And here's what Isaiah has to say, is the second chapter. In the last days, the mountain of the Lord's temple will be established, and the highest of the mountains. It will be exalted above the hills, and all nations will stream to it. Many peoples will come and say, let us go up to the mountain of the Lord, to the temple of the God of Jacob. He will teach us his way so that we may walk in his paths. The law will go out from Zion, the word of the Lord from Jerusalem. He will judge between nations and will settle disputes for many people. And they will beat their swords into plowshares and their spears into pruning hooks. Nations will not take up sword against nation, nor will they train for war anymore. And what are we going to have after this invasion of Israel and is put down by God? There's going to be a remarkable time of peace. We'll have at least 5 years or more of extraordinary peace, where the dictators of the earth are restrained, where those who want to fight war are not going to be allowed to do it. And we say the word will go forth from Jerusalem, but I think it'll also be the Christians who are the defenders of Zion. And they will be teaching the word all over the world. There'll be a great revival, one of the greatest spiritual revivals that the world has ever known. And that's a time of peace and love. But during that time, or right after that time, the dictators of the earth are going to be restrained by God. And so they'll be held in check. This isn't the second coming. It's the way it's going to work. There's going to be a great move of God. And you read, the apostles came after the day of Pentecost, and they said, this is prophesied by the prophet Joel. In the latter days, I'll pour my spirit upon all flesh. Well, that's going to happen in our day. We're going to see a great turning to God of the nations of the earth after this battle, where God himself is going to defend Israel. Okay, now what comes next? Because it's going to be nice, and we're all going to be living at peace. But Paul wrote to the Thessalonians, he said, for you know very well that the day of the Lord will come like a thief in the night. While people are saying peace and safety, destruction will come on them suddenly as labor pains on a pregnant woman, and they will not escape. So when that time of peace comes on, when it's all coming to an end, it's a few years, then there's going to be a great tribulation. And people have just misunderstood all this stuff about the tribulation. But Paul said that they're going to say peace and safety, and sudden destruction will come upon them like travail on a woman with child. That you can see the sequence going down. Now, Jesus, what did he have to say? It's found in Matthew 24, 21, 22. For he said, then there will be great distress unequaled from the beginning of the world until now and never to be equal today. And in those days had not been cut short, no one would survive. But for the sake of the elect, those days will be shortened. Now, what is he saying? I want to emphasize that. He says, if those days wouldn't be shortened, there wouldn't be one human being alive on the face of the earth. I mean, that's what he says. I mean, there'll be no flesh will remain. So this is the tribulation that people are talking about, and it's going to be terrible. And Paul said, sudden destruction is going to come upon you. And what I think, very frankly, is that the only thing that will fulfill what the word of Jesus, that I'm going to give you in a minute, is some kind of an asteroid strike on the globe. It's sudden destruction. There's not going to be some nuclear war. We're not going to be allowed to blow this earth up. But an asteroid coming down, I wrote one called The End of the Age, and it was an asteroid that's about 1 kilometer, about 0.6 miles, weighed about 3 billion pounds, came hurtling down. And that would pretty much fulfill what Jesus, of course, he said. And let's look again at 24 of Matthew. He said, immediately after the distress of those days, the sun will be darkened, and the moon will not give its light. The stars will fall from the sky, and the heavenly bodies will be shaken. And then will appear the sign of the Son of Man in heaven, and all the peoples of the earth will mourn when they see the Son of Man coming in the clouds of heaven with power and great glory. And he will send his angels with a loud trumpet call, and they will gather his elect from the four winds from one end of the heaven to the other. Now, that tribulation is going to be so bad that unless it was shortened, nobody would be alive, and the sun will be darkened. Well, what will darken the sun? Well, if an asteroid hits the earth, there will be a cloud of dust thrown into the atmosphere, and you won't be able to see the sun or the moon. It'll be hard to move on that. And there'll be times, if there's some antichrist or something like that, there'll be a time from that if that's what's going to happen. But the man of sin to be revealed. But that's what, and it doesn't say you're going to get raptured ahead of it. It doesn't say that at all. It said immediately after the tribulation, then the Lord's going to send his angels to gather his elect from the four corners of the earth. And it will happen after. So you read the Bible, it's very clear. It's not mystery. It's clear.
Yeah.
You know.
Well, if we knew this before, giving this word, but also what a time to pray. I mean, we live in a day that we've never seen before.
But again, I want to relate to you again. There's going to be a war. Ezekiel 38 is going to be the next thing down the line. Then a time of peace. Then maybe the end. But nobody knows the day or the hour when the Lord's going to come back. He said the angels don't know it. And only the Father knows it. So I'm not saying this is the second coming, but I am saying there are things that people have thought would be during a millennial time with the coming of Jesus that are going to happen in our lifetime. And the next thing is the election that's coming up in just a few weeks, at which time, according to what I believe the Lord told me, the president is going to be reelected. I'm saying by all means, get out and vote for whoever you want to vote for, but by all means, let your voice be heard. But it's going to lead to civil unrest of great proportion, then a war against Israel and so forth and so on. So as Terry said, I think it's time to pray. But ladies and gentlemen, that's the word. You ask what's going to happen next. That's what's going to happen next.
You know, I think of the book that was written a number of years ago, How Shall We Then Live?
Yeah.
It's a time to think about that.
All right. Well, let's pray. Father,
yes.
We thank you for the Word of God. We thank you for a more sure foundation. And we thank you for Jesus, who's our rock. And Lord, despite everything that may happen in the civic world, everything that may happen among the nations of the earth, this is my Father's world, and I rest me in that thought. And so right now, I pray for the anointing of the Lord to come upon this audience, to come upon this nation. It's your country, Lord. Take charge of your land. And we nullify any decree that has been issued against the people of God. And we know that the day is coming where we'll have peace, and the word will go forth in a great revival. We look forward to that. In Jesus' name, amen.